It's a lovely, pleasant Sunday morning. Only just, it's nearly midday. I'm on the allotment and just checking on things. And I think what I'm going to do today is make some changes. Let me show you. So we know that this isn't doing much. The 1.5 rows of choice sum that bolted. So what I'm going to do is half of that row, I'm going to move this kale, this curly kale, down into the choice sum. I've got things to go in there later on that won't need netting, but with all that choice curly kale and this choice sum, pak choy together, I can do a proper netting over here for the time being. I'm also, what I'm going to do first though, is I'm going to pull out the shallots. They are going, a lot are going to seed. These are the seed columns, seed shoots, I don't know what you'd call them. I don't think I'm going to get much more growth out of them. So I'm going to take them out. If they're small and tiny, what I'll do is I'll dry them and store them to use as seed shallots for next year. So that'll be the first job. So this is the harvest. It's quite a lot. This is Wilco's 2 for £5 seed shallots, little sets. And so I'm actually really impressed. I actually didn't think I was going to get this many out. And obviously some are much larger than others. Some have separated and some didn't. It's, you know, it's quite a mixture. So what I'm going to do is, actually this is maybe something you can help me on. I'm going to research how to best store these. I know they have to be dried out and trimmed and stored, but I need to find out really what's the best way to actually do it. So I'll research that. I'll leave them here for the time being. Go home later on and have a research. But I think for my first harvest this year, I'm really impressed. That's a full harvest. Quite a lot of shallots, as I say, for a fiver. Whether it's going to be worth it, I don't know, because obviously, you know, how many of these shallots would fit inside a pickle jar? Maybe one, two, there's maybe three pickle jars there, and a pickle jar's only a quid, so we'll see. We'll see if it's worth it, and what I may do is just leave them, every single one of them, as sets for next year. But yeah, there you go. First harvest of this year. So that's what it looks like now. There's some more room for some more brassicas at the end. But yeah, I'm quite pleased with that. I didn't have enough scaffolding net to go all the way down at the back, so I've just popped some other green net. Some normal netting just at the end to close it off, just stop the birds getting in there. It's really the birds, not so much worried about caterpillars and stuff. Hopefully the kale will take into its new place. I've given it a good water. I'll check again tonight and give it another water. But everything is dry. It's just like a complete saga of watering and weeding at the moment. But there you go. Them's the breaks. That's it. I'm going to go home. It's half past one. Ooh, been down a couple of hours now. Could go home, get some refreshment, have a rest, and then come down later on to do more weeding and stuff. These poor old beans, they keep on falling over. I'll have one of whatever they're drinking, please. Here we go. Lovely afternoon. It's midday. It's Monday, the 5th of June. Tomorrow will be anniversary of D-Day. Incredible. Yeah, I am actually really disappointed. Just watch the weather forecast. As you see, I'm wearing my coat again. Temperature's 12 degrees, but there is a really nasty northeasterly wind coming off that North Sea, which is just a few miles in that direction. And it's really making the place cold, and the weather is going to be like this for the next few days. So whereas the rest of you all over the rest of England, apart from Scotland, my commiserations, are going to be in your 20 degrees, I'm going to be sitting down here at 12 to 13 degrees for nearly the rest of the week. So while you're topping up your suntan, I'm going to be here looking at my very cold, dejected allotment. We need that heat. I mean, it's one thing to be dry, but cold and dry, it doesn't make for good big solid plants. So yeah, so either give us some rain or give us some heat. I'm not going to do too much today. I'm just picking out a few weeds here and there. To be honest, the weather doesn't make me want to do much, but yeah, there will be more, obviously. I'll catch you all guys later. So here we go, it's Tuesday, about 1 o'clock. It's cold on the allotment, it's just 11 degrees, and with a northerly breeze as well, you can, you know, knock at least 1 degree off that. So what I'm going to do, I'm not going to bother filming it, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull up all of the garlics, and I'm going to take them down to the table, which where I've covered the shallots for the time being, because I thought it might be drizzly today. But although it's cold and miserable, there's absolutely no precipitation at all. So I'm going to pull them all up and I'm going to see what I get, and I'll show you in a second. Okay, exhibit A, 20 bulbs. I believe these are solent whites, or I'll put the name up on the screen. I bought these were $3.99 for 20 cloves, and as you see, they've made a reasonable size, not as big as I would have expected. I think these should be slightly bigger, but these, apart from two which never actually grew, there you go, those two, they've all bulbed and they've all partitioned. I can actually feel the cloves in the heads. So even if these aren't as big as I need, there's still plenty here as long as they dry off without going mouldy. None of them showed signs of mould, which is excellent. But there's plenty there to act as seed cloves for next year. Really, that's all I'm interested in at the moment, is gathering for next year. Being more self-sufficient and not spending any money on stuff. So I'm quite pleased with those. Let's go and get the shop-bought garlic now. And here we have the shop bought. As you see, difference in size. A couple were mouldy, which I understand, because these were probably more intended for more of a Spanish climate, but only a couple were mouldy on the outside. The rest seem to be doing well. Yes, they have gone into cloves. And all in all, this is 99 pence worth. This is three garlic bulbs for 99 pence divided into cloves. So I mean, I will. Obviously, the truth is in the tasting. So I will try them as garlic, and obviously I will use these to actually eat, whereas those ones I'm going to keep for seed once they've dried out. But I am quite impressed with these. If it was a better year for them, I'm sure these would have got us much bigger. You can see how big the stems are, so I'm sure that these would have got much bigger and given a good crop. So those people that turn around and say, oh no, you can't grow shop-bought stuff. There you go. There's some of the proof that you actually can. Quite pleased with both of those. £3.99. Bought for growing. £1, actually it was 99p to be honest. Organic garlic, small bulbs that actually have worked out and grown garlic. Quite pleased. Now that space there is where I'm going to put in the tomatoes I bought down the other day in the wheelbarrow. So I'll have a row of tomatoes up there. Yeah, job well done. And as well as the harvest of garlic, I just grabbed some of the radishes, the catch crops from under the brassica netting, and I'll have those with my salads. Everything is beginning to come together, guys. It really is.